wyke.
Sometimes I'm up, but he follows round like some drum.
honey, honey, oh my.
Go to work, he'd come home, I'd I'd make him a drink, we'd have dinner. And then I found out. Single, he told me. Single my ass. Not only was he married, oh no, he had six wives. So the next night when he came home, I mixed him his drink as usual. You know, some guys just can't hold their arsenic. And he kept screaming, "You've been screwing the milkman!" And then he ran into my knife. He ran into my knife 10 times.
If you'd have been there, if you'd have seen it, I bet you would have done the same.
Miss Cortez, the bunny. As long as I told you, you didn't knock him to bunk down. Please, you guys on me. Let's talk to my friend Dad. What did you do it? Not guilty.
My sister Veronica and I, we did this double act with my husband Charlie while he traveled around with her. For the last number in our act, we did these 20 acrobatic tricks in a row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, split, spread eagle, slip-knot, backflips, one right after the other. Well, this one night, we're in Cicero, the three of us, up in a hotel room, boozing and having a few laughs, when we ran out of ice. So I went out to Tesla. I come back, I open the door. There's Veronica and Charlie. Doing the number 17, the spread eagle.
Well, I was in such a state of shock, I completely blacked out. I can't remember a thing.
It wasn't until later when I was washing the blood off my hands I even knew they were dead.
He had it coming, he had it coming, he had it coming, he had it coming.
He was a real artistic guy, sensitive, a painter. But he was always trying to find help. He'd go out every night looking for himself. And on the way, he found Gladys, Rosemary, and Ernest. I guess you could say we broke up. Artistic differences. He saw himself alive, and I saw him dead.
Prepare to do. And don't you know that it has washes that one too? When you're good to mama, mama's good to you.
Look at this, mama. The tribunal called me the crime of the year. And the news says, not in memory, do we recall so fiendish, so horrible, a double homicide.
Yeah, baby, you're gonna buy that kind of publicity. You took care of Mama, and Mama took care of you. I set your trial date for March 5th. March 7th, you'll be acquitted, and March 8th, do you know what Mama's gonna do for you? She's gonna get you on a vaudeville tour.
I've been on a lot of vaudeville tours, Mama. What kind of dough are we talking about?
Yeah, it's a crazy world, kid. They brought the baseball players wearing lipstick and rouge and working the palace, making $5,000 a week.
I said, what kind of dough are we talking about, Mama?
Well, I've been talking to the boys at William Morris, and due to your recent sensational activities, I can get you $2,500.
$2,500? The most me and Veronica ever made together was $350.
That was before Billy Flynn, before Cicero, and before Mama.
Mama, I always wanted to play at Big Jim's Calissimo. Could you get me that?
Big Jim's, that's another story. That might take another phone call.
Yeah, and how much would that phone call cost?
Ah, Velma, you know me, you're my favorite. You're the classiest name in this whole joint. You're like family to me, like my own. I'll do it for $50.
$50 for a phone call? You must have got a lot of wrong numbers, Mama.
If you want my gravy, pepper my ragu, spice it up for Mama.
Divorce. The reasons don't count as the grounds.
temporary insanity, self-defense.
What's your grounds?
My grounds are that I didn't do it.
So who did?
Well, I'm sure I don't know. I completely blanked out. I can't remember a thing. The only thing is, I'm sure I didn't do it. I pretended it's hard in the whole wide world. Tell my mama.
You bet your ass you have, Velma.
Ben, being drunk,
grounds.
Just ask your lawyer.
Well, I ain't got a lawyer.
As they say in Southampton.
Guess you don't like my girl.
Oh, Hail Mary.
Robertson, relax. Relax. Besides, in this town, murder is a form of entertainment. Besides, in 47 years, Cook County had never hung a woman yet. So it's 47 to 1, they won't hang you.
As always, the first time.
Ah, Belle, a conviction, maybe.
A conviction, maybe?
Yeah, that's right.
Well, what's that like? In jail?
Where else, Marshal Bill?
Oh, Jesus, Mary and Joseph!
Why, you know everybody.
Laugh!
What do I give a damn about her for? Enough of these trashy religious fanatics. I think I should retire my cell and take a wee nap and answer some fan mail. We're waiting when lunch is served, Mama.
My pleasure, Velma.
So that's Velma Kelly.
Yeah.
She sure don't look like a Kelly to me.
Oh, Kelly's her stage name. You know, that Velma's really something. She wears nothing but black narcissist perfume and never makes her own bed.
I thought you had to.
No, I take care of that for her.
You make her bed.
Not exactly. You see, Velma pays me $5 a week, and then I get the Hungarian 50 cents, and she
does. But she needs the money for it.
Hey, handle it! Jim, what report do you make?
Not give you the key.
That's all she ever says. Anyway, Velma pays me $5, and she has her laundry set out. And then she has a meal sent in from Worcester's drugstore around the corner. That costs her 20. And you know who's defending her, don't you?
No. Who's defending
Mr. Billy Flynn, best criminal lawyer in all Chicago, that's all. Boy, what he don't know about juries and women.
Well, how'd you get Billy Flynn?
Not by praying, dearie. First he gives me $100, and then I make a phone call.
I see, and how much does he get?
$5,000.
$5,000?
Well, he's worth every cent. Never lost a case for a female client yet.
Never?
Never. And me now, happy to make that phone call to you, dearie.
Thanks for filling me in. We'll talk later, I guess.
You bet we will.
$5,000? Now where in the hell am I gonna find $5,000?
Ladies and gentlemen, a tap dance.
Oh, Ava. Ava from Union Camp. Amos, I know I've been sinful, but I'm changing. And all I want now is to make up to you for what I've done. And I will, just as soon as I get out of here.
And I can get out of here, too.
You see, there's this lawyer, and he costs $5,000.
I'm sitting here fighting for work, Roxanne. The answer is no.
Oh, Amos, I know I've lied to you. I know I've cheated on you with other men.
Oh, Amos, I've even stolen money out of your pants pockets while you were sleeping.
But he never stopped loving you. And I always thought, my Amos, he's so manly and so attractive and so sexy.
Honest. $5,000.
It's my honest name, for Christ's sake!
Come on, I get it for you, Roxy.
And now, presenting the one, the only, the sole prince of the courtroom, Mr. Billy Flynn.
Thank you. Keep your money, that's it.
Thank you. first thing we gotta work on is sympathy from the press. They're not all a pushover like that fair sunshine. Chicago's got a tough town. So, I decided to rewrite your life story. It starts tomorrow in the Star. From convent to jail.
Convent? Oh, Mr. Flynn, you'll never believe that.
The only thing you gotta remember is remorse, regret. You're sorry, okay? Sorry. You would give your life and gladly to bring it back. And when they ask why you killed it, all you can remember is some terrible argument. And he said he was gonna kill me. And you can still see him coming towards you with these wild, angry eyes. And get this, you both reach for the gun. That's your ground, self-defense.
Mr. Flynn, the reporter's in here.
Let him in, Butch. And remember, remorse, regret, and you both reach for the gun. Good day, gentlemen. Mary Sunshine, I'm sure you all know my client, Miss Roxy Hart.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm just so glad that you all came to see me. I guess you want to know why I shot the bastard.
Sit down, Tommy. Mr. Billy Flynn sees the press conference where? Notice how his mouth never moves.
Almost.
Where did you come from?
Yes, he's still here.
And your parents?
Very wealthy.
Where are they now?
6 feet under.
But she was granted one more start. The count.
I'm saying goodbye.
Where did you get here?
1920.
Comprehensible, comprehensible. today this well-to-do ugly bootlegger. He used to like to take me out and show me off. Ugly guys like to do that. Once it said in the paper, Scanlon's Al Capelli sing with cute little red-headed Kareem. That was me. I clipped it out and saved it. Look, I'm gonna tell you the truth. Not that the truth really matters, but I'm gonna tell you anyway. Thing is, see, I'm older than I ever intended to be. And all of my life I wanted to be a dancer in vaudeville, have my own act. But no, no, no. They always turned me down. It was one big world full of no. Then Amos came along, sweet, safe Amos, who never says no. You know, some guys are like mirrors. And when I see myself in Amos's face, I'm always a kid. You can love a guy like that. Look, I've got to tell you something now, and I hope it ain't too crude, but in the bad department, Amos was zero. When we went to bed, he made love to me like, well, like he was fixing a carburetor or something.
I love you, honey, I love you.
Anyway, to cut a long story short, I started fooling around, and then I started screwing around, which is fooling around without dinner. I gave up the vaudeville idea, because I guess, after all those years, you figure opportunities just passed you by. Oh, but it ain't. Oh, no, 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 but it ain't. If this bling guy gets me off, and with all this publicity, now I got me a world full of lips. My name on everybody's lips has got me Roxy, the lady raking in the chips. It's got me Roxy.
Baby.
got some bad news.
What do you mean?
I mean the tour. The whole tour. It's canceled. Ouch. Here, kiddo.
Canceled?
Yeah. I've been getting calls from the boys at William Morris all day. We don't want her. She's washed up. She's a blonde. You know how it hurts, Mama, to hear that about someone she cares for?
Oh, yes, sure.
All you read about today is that Hart kid. She's hot.
Hey, Mama. I got an idea. Suppose I call that Hart kid instead of the sister after me.
Now, that's what I call using the old canoodle.
Brand new hubby, no.
going to change. When she returns, she notices something rather odd. Extremely odd. She disappears for a second, but when she returns, she gently awakens Harry.
Oh, Harry!
Do you believe what you see or what I tell you?
What I see?
Wake up, drive back to her! Please direct your questions to our counsel.
You're not my counsel. I want my money back.
It's not your mother's money. It's your mother's money.
Get out of here.
Father, John.
No.
Excuse me, Miss Pat. Did you know those two girls personally?
Did I know those two girls personally?
Is that your question?
Yes, that's my question. Oh!
Hi, Trixie. I'm Ian Ross. Boy, what a hell of a socialite, too. Her mother owns all the pineapples in Hawaii.
What the hell do I care about pineapples? Have you got my trial date?
Yeah. Take it easy, kid. I'll get it to you.
Mr. Flynn, look. There's a couple of things I'd like to discuss about my trial date, too.
Yeah, first things first, Abel. I'll get it to you, Pete.
Pineapples. I get a feeling you're in trouble, Roxy. Socialite. You'll lose again, Velma. There's only one person you can count on now, Roxy. There's only one person who can help you now, Velma.
And now, Miss Roxy Hart and Velma Kelly sing a song of unrelenting determination and unmitigated ego.
One thing I know.
My client. Somebody help me get her up.
And
welcome back. Ross is in there being looked over by the state medical examiner. Now she says she's gonna have a baby. Why didn't I think of that?
My dear little baby, my sweet little baby, look at my baby and me.
How you could delay the trial another second, Mr. Flynn. My readers wouldn't stand for it. The poor child, to have a baby born in jail.
I can assure you she'll come to trial at the earliest possible moment, and you can quote me on that.
Hey, everyone, I'm the father. I'm the father.
I think it's sweet. Real sweet, I call it. First time one of our girls has ever been knocked up.
I've got it, and it's brilliant. I'm going to get Amos to divorce you. That way, all the sympathy will go to you, not him. You will be the poor little deserted mother-to-be, and that creep is running out on you.
Papa. Daddykins. Dada. Did you hear me? No, you didn't. Nobody ever hears me. Nobody listens. Are you listening? Nobody listens.
And raised his voice up way out loud, and waved his arms and shook his leg. You'd notice him. If someone in a movie show yelled,
"Fire in the second row! This whole place is a powder keg!" Notice him.
And even without clucking like a hen, everyone gets noticed now and then. Unless, of course, that personage should be invisible, inconsequential.
You know when she's due? Early fall, September? That means you couldn't possibly be. But I want you to stop passing all those cigars in. I don't want you to give a damn when people...
When people what?
Laugh.
Laugh? Why would they laugh?
Because they can count. Can you count? Early fall, September? Here's a copy of Roxy's first statement. It says she hadn't copulated with you for 4 months preceding the event.
Well, that's right. We hadn't had no copula...
Hey, wait a minute.
But I want you to forget about that right now. My client needs your support.
That means I couldn't possibly
divorce her? Is that what you said? My God, man. You wouldn't divorce her at a time like this. Would you?
You're goddamn right. I'll divorce her. That's what I'll do. She probably wouldn't even notice. Suppose you was a little cat residing in a person's flat, who fed you fish, who scratched your ear, notice him. Suppose you was a woman wet and sleeping in a double bed beside one man for 7 years. You'd notice him. A human being is made of more than air. With all that bulk, you're bound to see him there. Unless, of course, that person next to you is invisible, inconsequential. You know who.
Please, somebody! Can I have a glass of you're gonna do on the witness stand?
Yeah, I thought so.
Can I offer you just the teeniest bit of criticism?
Okay.
It stinks.
I'll talk to you later.
Okay.
Well, I guess I'll leave now, but not quietly. Please, may I have my action music?
Don't do that again. Okay, I got A. Master filed for divorce.
Yeah, so now what?
So now I can get him up on the stand and get him to admit that he made a terrible mistake. He still loves you. And of course, you still love him. So the jury will be falling over each other to play Cupid and get you back together again. Smart, huh?
Smart, huh?
And another thing.
And another thing.
When A. Master's on the stand, I want you to be knitting.
Knitting, for Christ's sake!
A baby doll.
I don't know how to knit.
Well, learn.
I don't want to learn.
I don't care what you don't want it. It'll look good.
That's no way to get a jury sympathy.
Oh, so now you don't need my advice, right?
It seems to me, Mr. Mouthpiece, that I'm the one who's getting all the good ideas around here. I am sick of everybody telling me what to do. You treat me like dirt, Billy Flynn. You treat me like I'm some dumb common criminal.
But you are a dumb common criminal.
The better than me agrees to make the list.
What happens to be saving your ass?
After all, you can steal.
If you ask me, you're getting a little too big for your bloom.
And who asked you?
Oh, so maybe you could appear in court without me too, huh?
Maybe I could. Just read the morning papers, Palsy. They love me.
Wise up, kid. They'd love you a lot more if you were hand. You know why? Because it'd sell more papers.
You're fired!
I quit.
Any lawyer in town would die to have my case.
You're a phony celebrity, kid. A flash in the pan. A couple of weeks, no one will even know who you are. That's Chicago.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, we'll just see about that. No! No! They want my biographic, too. No!
I'm sorry, Aaron. She still says no.
That much Hungarian I can't understand. Ask her once more.
I jammed your voicey stomach name. She says no.
Oh, I can understand that too. But Jesus Christ, don't you know she's a loser for sure? They'll tell us she'll sit in jail for years. You'll be convicted. How would you like that?
Uncle Sam, you ate the gas for the mental board home because they keep it at
Huh?
She says Uncle Sam is just unfair, and they'll not let her see to go to jail because she's innocent. Aaron, I think she's telling the truth.
Well, so what? What the hell has innocence got to do with this? Look, Miss Morgan, this is a court-appointed thing, you know. I don't get anything from this. Nothing at all, understand?
Well, what do you want me to do about it? I've done my best.
Not guilty.
You goddamn foreign honky nut.
Forgot to send me Uncle Sam, Nick.
Huh?
She says, well, Uncle Sam like her.
I don't give a goddamn what she says unless it's guilty.
Not guilty!
Yeah?
So you see now?
Well, here you go!
Not guilty! Not guilty! Not guilty! Not guilty! Not guilty! Not guilty!
Ladies and gentlemen, for your pleasure and your entertainment, I proudly present the one, the only, and her famous Hungarian rope trick.
After 47 years, a Cook County precedent has been shattered. Katalin Hunyak was hanged tonight for the brutal axe murder of her husband. The Hungarian woman's last words were, not guilty.
What I want you to wear.
I look like a lampshade and I don't want to wear it.
You're wearing whatever I tell you to wear. As a matter of fact, you're doing whatever I tell you to do. That was the deal, remember?
I don't remember nothing about a dress.
Oh, no. Please, Billy, you said. I mean, I'm scared. Right after they hang Hongyak, you remember that, don't you? Yeah. You said, please, Billy, I'll do anything you say. I'm really scared. Did you say that or didn't you?
Yeah, maybe I did.
So shut up about the dress. Now, we're clear on everything you're going to understand, right?
Don't worry about me. I've been up all night rehearsing. I know every line.
Okay, let's get to my summation.
I'm gonna start with justice in America, blah, blah, blah. Then I'll want to your repentance, blah, blah, blah. And then I'll say, if sorrow could avail, Fred Casely would be here now. For she would give her life and gladly to bring the dead man back. You know.
That's all?
That's all. Then I say, but we can't do that, gentlemen. We may take her life as the state demands, but it won't bring Casely back. Then I'll go into my final statement, winding up with, we can't give her happiness, but we can give her one more chance. And that's all for you.
All for me. Yeah, like hell it is. It's me they want to save, not you.
It's my speech that's bringing them in. And it's my speech that'll save your ass.
If they can see you through all these crappy ladies.
Look, I'm running this.
Oh, screw you, you goddamn crook.
Shut up, you dirty little...
Mr. Flynn, not up here.
Okay, thank you. You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Hey, look, don't worry about it. I've been in this business a long time, and believe me, you got nothing to worry about.
Yeah, I've got nothing to worry about. But Billy, I am worried.
It's a circus, kid. A three-ring circus. Kid, go. You are one of the biggest stars. The biggest.
Give them the old razzle dazzle, razzle dazzle them. Give them an act with lots of flash in it, and the reaction will be passionate. Give them the old hocus pocus, beat them, feather them. Give on the old.
justice.
The state of Illinois.
Versus Roxy Hart.
To the murder of Fred Casely. Thank you.
The state calls Amos Hart to the stand. Blah, 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 blah. Tooth self you got.
I certainly do.
Question. Sergeant Fogarty, what happened next? Answer, Roxy Hart.
I shot him because he was walking out on me, the louse. Signed, Roxy Hart.
Do you recognize the signature?
Yes, it's the signature of the lady who used to be my wife.
Exactly. Take the witness.
Hello, Amos.
That's right, Amos, but my name is Amos.
Amos, you are at present obtaining a divorce from the defendant.
Yes.
When did you file suit?
A few weeks ago.
Was there any reason for filing for a divorce at this particular time?
Well, I'll say so. The paper said that she was expecting a stranger.
Well, that's hardly grounds for divorce, is it?
Too much of a stranger.
Oh, by that you mean you doubted the paternity of the child?
Well, I most certainly did.
Did you even bother to question her? Did you even bother to ask if you were the father?
Well, no, but
you just jumped to a conclusion. Do you call that plain square? Let me ask you this, Hart. If you became convinced you were wrong, you'd be man enough to admit it, wouldn't you? If you became convinced that you were the father of Roxy Hart's child, which she swears.
She does?
I do.
She does. Step down, Betty. The defense calls Roxy Hart.
Roxy Hart to the stand. Blah, 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 blah. Tooth, self you got.
I do.
What is your name?
Roxy Hart.
Roxy. I have here a statement in which you admit having illicit relations with the deceased Fred Casely. Is this statement true or false?
I'm afraid that's true.
You're an honest girl, Roxy. Could you tell us, when did you first meet Casely?
When he sold Amos and me our furniture. Also, he was a regular patron at the nightclub where I was a member of the chorus.
And your personal relationship with him. Could you tell the jury when did that begin?
When I permitted him to drive me home one night.
Hey, Chicky.
Hello, Mr. Casely.
My night for ducks, ain't it? Why don't I drive you home? I got my car right around the corner. It's raining so hard and all.
He was such a fine gentleman, and he dressed so elegantly.
You were married, Mrs. Hart.
I know, and I don't think I would have gone with him if me and Mr. Hart hadn't quarreled that very morning.
Quarreled?
Oh, yes, sir.
Oh, I suppose it was his fault.
Oh, no, sir, it was my fault. It seems I just couldn't stop pestering him.
Pestering him about what?
Oh, Amos, I don't want to work in that cheap Southside nightclub. And I don't like you working those long hours at the garage, either. I want you home with me. I want to do your laundry. I want to iron your shirts. I want to darn your socks. I want a real home and a child.
So you drifted into this illicit relationship with Casely because you were unhappy at home?
Most unhappy.
I love you, honey. I love you.
Why didn't you stop?
I did try to, but Mr. Casely, he'd plead and he'd say...
I can't live without you. I can't live without you. Whoa. I can't live without you.
I love you, honey, I love you.
I was being torn apart!
Roxy Hart! You have been accused of the murder of Fred Casely. Are you guilty or not guilty?
Not guilty! Not guilty! Oh, we killed him, yes, but...
Roxy, do you remember the night of February 14th?
Yes. Oh, yes, sir.
Could you tell the jury the happenings of that?
Well, it was after 2 a.m., but I was at work, and I stopped in at an all-night grocery store to pick up some baking powder to make cupcakes for my Amos. Oh, Amos just loved my cupcakes. And then I went right home. I had a bath, I was getting ready for bed, when suddenly the doorbell rang. I thought it was my friend Gloria, so I slipped into my kimono and I went to the door.
And who was there?
Fred Casely!
And what did he say, Roxy?
Hello, Roxy. I had to see you once more.
Why, Fred?
That note you wrote me, telling me it was all over, telling me we had to quit, telling me it could never end in happiness. Why did you write that note, Roxy?
Because I have reformed, because I have seen the error of my ways, and I am... Oh,
and did he go as you asked him to?
I object to counsel's leading the witness.
Sustained.
I'll rephrase the question. And what did you say?
Oh, go away!
I tried to close the door, but he forced his way in. I ran into the bedroom, but he followed me.
And then? Look, just have one little drink with me and I'll go. Why did you scream?
I was afraid of waking up the neighbors. Please, no good will come of this. And besides, I love my husband.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
So, you told him you loved your husband, and what did he say to that? Doesn't matter. You're mine! You're mine! You're mine!
I can't go out!
Oh, no, no, Roxy, you must. The jury had a right to know.
Amos and me are gonna have a baby.
And what did he say to that?
I'll kill you before I see you have another man's child.
Diagram! Where were you at this moment?
I was by the victrola.
And where was Casey? Show the jury.
He was also by the victrola.
Show the jury what happened next.
In his heat of passion, he ripped up my kimono and threw me on the bed. Mr. Hart's revolver was lying there between us. He grabbed for the gun. I knocked it from his hand and he whirled me aside.
And then?
And then we both reached for the gun.
But I got it first.
You did!
And then he came toward me with this funny look in his eyes.
What kind of look?
I don't know. Angry, wild.
I mean to kill you. Do you think he meant to kill you?
Oh, yes, sir.
Then it was his life or yours.
And not just mine. So I closed my eyes and shot. Hey!
In defense of your life.
To save my husband's innocent unborn child.
Throughout this ordeal has been truly extraordinary.
I bet.
Sitting next to her attorney, Mr. Billy Flynn, she weeps, but she cannot find a handkerchief.
A handkerchief?
Oh, the bailiff has brought her one.
That's my bet.
She smiles at him graciously. She looks around her, bewildered, seeming to want something. Oh, it's a glass of water.
A glass of water? That's my cue.
Oh, she looks simply radiant in a beautiful, stylish blue lace dress with elegant silver shoes.
With rhinestone
buttons.
Kevin, don't break my radio!
Well, she stole my shoes!
You shouldn't have left them lying around!
So she stole my lingerie and my lawyer and my publicity! And then she steals my shoes!
What do you expect? She's a lowbrow. The whole world's got lowbrow. Things ain't what they used to be, Velma.
They sure ain't, Mama. They sure ain't.
Whatever happened to Verity Day? Pure exit, Christmas. Why is it everyone's out in the pain in the air? How charming. Now every son of a bitch is a stake in the ground. Whatever happened to Claire? Oh, there ain't no gentleman to open up the door. There ain't no lady to help, there's only kids and whores. And even hey, they'll lock you down. Nobody's got no class.
or what even say, oh, when they're passing their gas. Whatever happened to Glenn?
The final day of the trial of Roxy Hart has come. A hush has fallen over the courtroom as Mr. Billy Flynn prepares his summation to the jury. The next voice you will hear will be that of Mr. Flynn, the champion of the downtrodden.
Ladies and gentlemen, you and I have never killed. We can't know the torture, the agony that Roxy Hart went through then. This drunken beast, Fred Casey, forced his way into our home, forced liquor upon her, and physically abused her. At that moment, mother love and a deep concern for her neighbor stirred within her. She shot him, yes. We won't deny that. But she has prayed for forgiveness for what she has done ever since. We may take her life as the stake demands, but it won't bring Casey back. Look. Look closely at that frail figure. Hasn't she suffered enough? We can't give her happiness. We can give her one more chance. You have heard my calling. Call her temperance. Call her adulteress. Call her murderess. But, despite what prosecution says, things are not always what they appear to be. The defense rests.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, have you reached your verdict?
We have, Your Honor.
Will the defendant please rise? What is the verdict?
We find the defendant.
You should see what's going on there. There was a gunshot and a space shot, a husband, her mother, his attorney. It's full of the walls. It's awful. It's terrible.
What a story.
I'm Roxy Hart. I'm the famous Roxy Hart. Don't you want my picture? I'm Roxy Hart. What's going on around here? What the hell happened?
You were found not guilty. That's what happened.
Oh, the reporters. The publicity. My name in the papers. I was counting on that.
You know, your gratitude is overwhelming. But what the hell? I'm only in it for the money.
So you get $5,000 and I wind up with nothing.
You're a free woman, Roxy Hart. And God save Illinois. Well, I guess that just about wraps it up for us. It's the last you'll be seeing of me, too. My exit music, please.
All I care about is love.
Roxy?
Oh, what do you want?
I want you back, Roxy. You said you still wanted me, and now it's the baby. Our baby.
Baby? What baby?
Gee, that's what you pay me for. There ain't no baby.
There ain't no baby?
That's right.
I still love you, Roxy.
They didn't even want my picture. I don't understand that. They didn't even want my picture.
My exit music, please.
Whoa.
good? Isn't it grand? Isn't it great? Isn't it swell? Isn't it fun?
Ladies and gentlemen, the biggest theatre Chicago's finest home of family entertainment is proud to announce our first, for the first time anywhere, that there has been an act of this nature. Not only one little lady, but two. Get rid of them in the papers, and now here they are, Chicago's own caterpillars, those two scintillating singers, Miss Foxy Hart and Velma Kelly.
Yeah.